Good morning to all my dear children. We were studying the chapter Resources and Development from Geography, and today also we would continue with the same chapter. On the basis of ownership, we have four types of resources: individual resources, community owned resources, national resources, and international resources. Now let us study about individual resources. The resources which are owned privately by individuals are called individual resources. For example, in rural areas, farmers have land given to them by the government, and at the end of a month or a particular year, they have to make payment. In urban areas, we have plots and houses. Every individual has bought that land and they can do whatever they want to do with it. They can build a house, do plantation, etc. Then comes to the community-owned resources. As the name suggests, the resources which all the people of a community can use. For example, grazing grounds, common ponds, public parks, picnic spots, etc. But don't forget that here, people will not have individual rules as it is meant for public. So everyone is given similar rights. Now students, let us come to national resources. Well, these are the resources that belong to nation. Roads, railways, minerals, forests, etc. are all the examples. Beta, you must have seen that sometimes in order to construct roads, canals and railways, private properties are demolished. Of course, they are paid a certain amount of money by the government. But in order to build these roads, canals, etc. for public interest, the government has legal power to acquire even public property. Territorial water and the resources within it is also a part of national resource. What is territorial water? It refers to the oceanic area up to 12 nautical miles from the coast. Nautical mile, it is a unit to measure distance in ocean. It means that we have full right over territorial water and its resources. Then comes the last division, that is international resources. These resources neither belong to country, nor community, nor an individual. For example, the area in ocean next to territorial water up to 200 nautical mile is called exclusive economic zone. And beyond exclusive economic zone, we have open ocean. The resources in these regions can be used by other countries also, but by the permission of international organizations, which actually regulate these resources. Do you know that India has got the right to mine manganese nodules from the bed of Indian Ocean, which lies beyond the exclusive economic zone? Here in this picture, you can see the division of resources on the basis of ownership. So now, let us study about the classification of resources on the basis of status of development. We have potential resource, developed resource, stock, and ultimately reserve. Potential resource. These are the resources which are found in a region in abundance. But we have not been able to develop them properly, and we can use them in future. Solar energy, wind energy in Gujarat and Rajasthan, they are the best examples, but we have not tapped on it. Next is developed resources. The resources which are surveyed and the quality and quantity have been determined for utilization. Let us take an example. We know that how much of coal is there in India. We also know that how much of iron ore is there in Chota Nagpur Plateau. And of course, this has been done by scientific surveys. And we have an estimation about their quantity and quality. And this is all because of technology. Hence, we know how much to use it and how much to preserve it. So these resources are present. We are using them because we have technology to use them. Then comes to the stock. The resources which can fulfill our needs, but we do not have the required technology to use them, comes under stock. Last, reserve. They are a part, or you can say subset of stock, which are yet to be put into use. These can be used for meeting future requirement. For example, river water can be used to generate hydroelectric power. But till now, their use has been limited. So students, this is all for today. Now at the last, I would like to give you some questions as assignment. Please go through these questions and write down their answers. If you are not able to understand it, watch the video once again and you will definitely get the answer.